Hello, I'm State Representative Cris Dush. I represent Jefferson County and the northern half of Indiana County, which is Pennsylvania's 66th Legislative District. I'm here today with Tim Schaefer from the Fish and Boat Commission. And I want to start talking today. One of the biggest things that's in my district is Kyle Lake.
Yep.
You guys have been doing the restoration on the dam, mm-hmm. and it's big physically and with our fishermen.
Yep.
So if you could explain a little bit about what's going on.
Absolutely. And for anybody not familiar with Kyle Lake, you can actually see it from Route 80.
Yes.
When you're heading near Dubois. So Kyle Lake is one of a number of high hazard unsafe dams that we manage on behalf of the Commonwealth statewide.
Not any longer.
Not this one. No. So what it is so we had old infrastructure. Think of a road, think of a bridge, things get old, you need to get repaired. We got to the same point with Kyle Lake. So we are really, really happy to have the money released. Thanks to you, thanks to Senator Scarnati, thanks to Governor Wolf working together to get the money released for this project. It was a $4.3 million project.
Yes.
Where we went in, we rebuilt the spillway at the dam, put some new surface on the front of it, basically rebuilt the whole thing. And literally we signed the paperwork noting that it was finished back in December. We're about to refill the lake. We anticipate that it'll be full this summer for the anglers and boaters of your district and statewide to enjoy.
And what I'm also excited about is you've provided some new habitat there.
Absolutely.
Can you describe what you've done there?
Happy to, sure, yeah. So we worked locally with the Red Bank Creek Watershed Trust,
yes.
Penn State Dubois, Jefferson County Conservation District, Pennsylvania Lake Management Society, and frankly, Kyle Lake is gonna be better than ever. We installed habitat structures in the lake that are a benefit to the game fish that are there.
Yes.
Worked with some of the entryways and the roadways coming down towards the lake to help anglers. Put in an ADA accessible fishing pier.
Yes.
That's gonna be a great local amenity. So, and as you know, one thing we're really excited about is all those habitat structures we post online where you can find them. So go onto the Fish and Boat Commission website, find Kyle Lake, and we put the GPS coordinates of where the habitat structures are so anglers can help to use them.
And that's a good lead into something else I wanted to talk about, which is your geographic mapping system.
Yeah.
Could you describe a little bit about that to the people so they understand?
Sure. So we have our mobile app, I think is what you're talking about. It's Fish Boat PA, spelled exactly like it sounds.
Yes.
And it's super easy to use. We have all of our access areas on there, as well as other access areas. So say you're somewhere in Jefferson County and you want to find where the closest access within 5, 10, 15 miles in. Go onto the app, click the Near Me feature, and you can find out where they are. Another thing that's really popular this time of year are our stocking schedules. Put the stocking schedules out on Friday, so they'll be in your district office as well as other legislators.
My car's going to be like a pickup truck tonight.
Good, take them out with you. But also, you can find them on the mobile app or on our website. Again, it's really easy. Go in there, type in Jefferson County or Indiana County, and it lists every stream that we stock there. And we encourage people to come join us for those. They're all open to the public. This year, you're going to be seeing more bigger fish than ever. We're doubling the number of brood fish. These are the 14 to 20 inch trout that we're stocking.
Yes.
You'll see a lot of those out there. Our golden rainbows or palominos, as some folks still call them, about double the number of those this year. So
yeah.
it should be a great trout season.
And so you're basically doubling the numbers statewide on
of the larger fish. So we'll still stock about 3.2 million fish.
Right.
That's typically what we stock every year. We're right on target for that again this year. But our hatchery staff has done a really good job and was able to work within the permit limits that we have and the funding that we have to squeeze a couple more big fish out for the anglers to enjoy.
So there are going to be a lot more happy anglers out there.
We think so. And again, we try to make it easy for them to get to those fish as easy as possible.
We've also got this fluctuation in the weather. Punxsie Phil announced an early spring yesterday, but we still are going to experience some pretty rapid changes in the weather. I'd like you to talk about what's going on with the cold water.
Yeah, I'm glad you asked about that. So a few years ago, we instituted a new requirement from November 1st through April 30th. It's mandatory to wear your life jacket in any boat 16 feet or less or any canoe or kayak, because the statistics really bear it out. If you fall in the water when it's cold, chances are you're not going to make it.
Right.
Most of our boating accidents happen in the summer. Most of the fatalities proportionally happen in the cold weather months. So we just really remind people it may be 50 degrees out today and feel like it's springtime, May or June. but that water is still really cold. So please, 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 if there's one thing you remember from this video, is wear your life jacket. Yep.
Thank you very much.
No problem.
I appreciate it.
Thank you.
I'm here at the Pennsylvania Great Outdoor Show. You can actually come down here and enjoy everything and get your license. So a 1, 3, or 5 year license, whichever suits you. And it's a great opportunity to get your license, be legal, get out there and start dropping a line in the water. Wrapping this interview up, but it's the beginning of a great week of magnificent opportunities to see all sorts of products, as well as things you can do here in Pennsylvania in the Pennsylvania Great Outdoors up home. And also there are tours, fishing, hunting, outdoor equipment, all sorts of things you can do here. In fact, you can even do like I did. I was blessed to actually be the first person here at the show to buy my fishing license. So it's a great opportunity. I hope everybody who can will take advantage of it. Thank you.